Hey everyone, it's Chris from Lion Punch Forge. We are going to do something new today, and I'm super excited. But before we get into that, I'd like to ask you, if you like what you see, please like and subscribe. The little button down there, the little red one, I think it's right here. It's hard to say when you're on camera. So if you like what you see, like and subscribe, share with your friends. Wanted to let you guys know that we are going to do some subscriber giveaways. At 200 subscribers, we'll give away something cool. But I'd like to really talk to you about the milestone giveaways. So at 500 subscribers and 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to give away a couple hammers that I've made. So feel free to ask your friends to like and subscribe and possibly win yourself a hammer. So let's get into what we're going to do today. First time for me, product review, and it is my pleasure to have this be my first. So Jim Brandvic, also known as the Horseshoe Engraver, makes some really awesome tools, and this one is shiny. Anyway, this is a 1-inch Concho kit. So his kit comes with a pancake die, 1-inch pancake die, and it's concentric, so anywhere you index that around the same shape is going to index and cut out that shape. So if you use this die twice, you won't have to do any cutting to get that little tab off. The other thing that comes in this kit is a couple impression dies, nice flower one and a sunshine one, and then some Chicago screws for on the back of the concho. Conchos are typically used as embellishment on a lot of Western saddles, holsters, belts. It's also used in a lot of Navajo silversmithing. You'll see a lot of that kind of stuff in Western art. These are really, really cool. I like the fact that Jim has an entire kit to just buy it, start making conchos, and today we're gonna see how easy it is. We'll do all that stuff on camera. So this is the kit. And it's awesome. I'm like shaking excited on how awesome this is. His pancake die looks just like any other pancake die I've used. It's nicely finished. His impression dies, very nice. The lines on there are not lines that are, you can't feel them with your hand. They're basically overlap marks from the milling process on the top of the dies, and it's kind of like mowing your lawn. You mow it one way, it looks different than you mow it back the other. It's like you see on baseball fields and stuff. That's just milling marks. It's not going to leave any kind of mark on your metal. The other thing that he has is his little doming kit. So the doming kit or die is male and female, and it's made from aluminum, so it's not something that you want to put a lot of pressure on, and it's not going to need it. All it is you stick your stamped concho in there, replace the top onto the die, and then punch it in, and you're good to go. Make yourself a nice little dome concho. So I say less talky, more worky, and let's go make a concho. But before we do that, I want to remind you that Jim and Lori's information is down in the comments there. You can find their Etsy page, their website, and all that fun stuff if you like this. So we are gonna see how easy it is to use. So yeah, there you go. Let's do it. All right, we're at the press. Got some copper here, and I'm going to place it inside the pancake die, like so, and then throw this little fella in the press. Make sure I keep Prudence out of the way. Prudence, the safety sheep, everybody, reminds us to be safe. So I'm gonna press this. It doesn't take much, just like any other pancake die. Watch out, Prudence. There you go.
No. Bump.
She didn't like that. I think it scared her. All right. Back this off. Take this out. Remove the concho. Give it a little tap tap. A little bigger tap tap. There it comes. Maybe. These ones, the little sharp corners are sometimes a little bit harder to get out. But there it goes. So we have this guy. Where's my camera? There it is. We have that guy. And what we're going to end up doing is taking the old tag off by taking it and re-indexing this somewhere else, right where we want it. So I'll do that real fast. Re-index that somewhere on the die that matches the pattern. And then it does not take much after that to get it again. Put that back in. Readjust prudence and go. That's it. Tap. And we have a concho cut out completely concentric. And there I go. So it's got a little bit of a burr on it, I think, because my copper was a little bit soft. So I'm gonna file that off, and then we'll come back and show the impression die size. I am also going to anneal this off screen, and we'll come back. All right, we're back from the annealing. What we're gonna do now is I have selected one of these two to go ahead and impress, and it's gonna be this one. I like the sunshine design because it's cold in Washington State and I want the sunshine. So we're gonna do that. So that little line is just an index mark. So I'll stick my concho right on that line, put my urethane on top, and then give it a good pressing. So let me go ahead and do that. Find a couple little bitty pieces of urethane. And throw him right in there. Where is Prudence? There she is. She'll be safe. Alright, and we'll go ahead and do our first pressing. Rotate it. Should get my urethane back in there. Press it again. Gotta keep on bumping the camera, I'm sorry. It's hard doing this while you're filming. Rotate it around again. Do another pressing. Okay. After first pressing, we have something that looks like that. And so I'm going to take him off. Take a look. We got a pretty nice impression. I think there's some more that could be done with that. Maybe. But that's our first pressing. I think that's pretty good. But I'm gonna anneal and come back. All right, we are back with the annealed concho. And now it's a little bit flat. So So we're going to try and give it some dimension. So Jim included a doming, aluminum doming kit for the 1-inch Conchos. So nicely engraved, and I expect nothing less from Jim, being, you know, the horseshoe engraver and all. Looks nice, nice and shiny. Who doesn't like shiny? All right. Gonna take our Concho, take the female side of the die, put our Concho face down, just like that, and it indexes in there nice, and then we'll stick our male portion right on top, and stick it in our press, and like I said before, this is not a high pressure operation. You want to be cognizant that the impression that you've put on the Concho, you don't want it to go away. So this is just going to push it down. That's probably about it. And we'll see what happens. All pretty. Domed Concho. So what we can do now is go around and stamp the outside of it with whatever design you want. I'm not going to do it on video or probably with this one, but the Chicago screws go right on the back, and then it allows you to screw this onto a belt or a holster or a saddle or whatever you want a Concho on. And then good. So I'm going to do a little bit of stamping just for fun, see what I can do. And we'll be back. Able to get my Concho all stamped and polished up. Here's my finished product. I'll bring it closer to the camera here. Zoom. There we go. Nice looking Concho. This was my first time ever using this kit, and it's pretty intuitive. You just follow the steps, use the same processes you use for your other pancake dies and impression dies, and you should be good to go. This was really, really easy and really fun to use. We'll go over the tools real quick on Zoom. So there you go. You got your pancake die, you got your impression dies, and then you have your 1-inch Concho doming tool. It indexes, it's made of aluminum, it's not gonna really mar. You're not gonna wanna put too much pressure in your press on this. This is just to dome it, light doming. And honestly, this thing is awesome. The versatility that this set has is transferable to any of your other tools, including Jim's other tools. So Jim has some other impression dies, like this fella, which is a pirate coin. And I wanted to see whether or not Jim's other dies worked well with this kit. So what I did was I made an impression out of a 1-inch disc for little pirate coin, and then made a pirate coin Concho. I did some hammer texturing on it, on the skull. Bring it in. That would make a super awesome Concho. Let's try and zoom it. There we go. Super cool. I love the texture the hammer put on it. I wanted to try and make it a little bit rustic, a little bit piratey. And to call it good, but it's not just Jim stuff that works with that. I'm really excited to try maybe an octopus die Concho. See how you can get, you know, a pretty good size stamping out of that and make a Concho out of it. That would be cool. You have other impression dies that are flowers. Just put a 1-inch disc on that. You're not gonna get the entire disc or the entire impression, but I think it's gonna be close enough to look pretty awesome. So those are always options. Zoom that. sky's the limit. I want to thank Jim and Lori real quick. Thank you for allowing me to do a review on your guys' products. I love them as usual. I'm going to go ahead and link your guys' pages down in the description of this video. And if you guys are liking what you're seeing, please subscribe. See if I can do this right. Little red button down here somewhere, yonder. Hit that little subscribe button. Throw us a like. Put some comments in there. And please stay tuned for our 200 subscriber, 500 subscriber, and 1,000 subscriber giveaways. If you guys have any questions, as always, feel free to contact me. And have a great day.